Solve the absolute value equation, problem number 7. The absolute value of 4x plus 9 equals the absolute value of x minus 5. In this absolute value equation, both of the absolute values are isolated, so we have to rewrite the problem with the positive version and the negative version. And it doesn't matter which side you are choosing to make this switch. I'm going to keep the first side alone, and then I'm going to choose the second one to first use the positive version and then rewriting it and using the negative version of this problem. And you have to be really careful that making it the opposite means to distribute this negative sign to both values inside the parentheses. So before we worry about that, we are going to solve the left side for x. So we're subtracting x from both sides, which gives us 3x plus 9 equal to negative 5, subtracting 9, which leaves us with 3x equals negative 14, and dividing 3 by both sides leaves us with x equals negative 14 over 3. This is the first solution we get for this absolute value equation. Now let's try to solve this second part. So let's distribute the negative sign to eliminate the parentheses. 4x plus 9 equals negative x and positive 5. Adding x to both sides of the equation gives us 5x plus 9 equals 5, subtracting 9, and we get 5x equals negative 4, dividing by 5, and x is equal to negative 4 over 5 is our second solution. Now, remember, we always need to check if our values actually make sense, meaning to give us a true statement. So starting with this first solution we got, plugging it into the original equation, we get 4 times negative 14 over 3 plus 9, which is equal to, again, plugging negative 14 over 3 in for x, minus 5 inside absolute value bars. Right over here, this is multiplication. We cannot apply cross simplification, so we just have to straight multiply. 4 times negative 14 over 3 gives me a negative 56 over 3, and because I know we're going to have to add these two values and we need the same common denominator, I'm going to convert this, making it a fraction, to the same denominator, which is 3, so we have to multiply the bottom and the top by 3. So converting this, which is an equivalent fraction, just having the same denominator, 9 times 3 is 27 over 3. And on here, again, before I'm able to add or subtract these two numbers, I have to get the same common denominator. In this case, again, it is 3, so I'm multiplying the denominator and numerator by 3. 14 over 3 minus 5 times 3 is 15 over 3. Now I can actually do this addition, so negative 56 plus 27 gives me a negative 29 over 3. And on the right side, negative 14 minus 15 also gives me a negative 29 over 3. Taking the absolute value of both of these gives me a positive fractional value, so 29 over 3 is equal to 29 over 3, which is a true statement. So, because I'm running out of space, I suggest you plugging the second value in to the original equation and see if you get a true statement. I can assure you, you should get a true statement. So your final answer for this problem is negative 14 over 3 and also negative 4 over 5. Both of these are valid solutions.